language, I mean, grammar of Tangut. The topic of today is the suffix of Tangut. So, first, but so, everyone knows Tangut so much. This is general information for the Shishu dynasty. It's located here in the northwest area of China. And this is main cities of Shisha dynasty. And from here, I will start. The Tangut language, so as you know well, belongs to the Tibet-Burma language group. And it was written in Tangut script. And the Tangut language has unique some features not found in both old Tibetan and old Burmese. And this is general information from typology. Tangut belongs to so-called subject-object verb language. And actually, also, the Tangut has so complicated verb phrases in some cases. For example, prefix including negative and perfect and something, and after then verb stem and auxiliary verb, and pronominal suffix, especially for pronoun for suffix and particle. So, for the presentation today, I explain just prefix and suffix in Tangut language. This is the main verb, I mean verb stem and auxiliary verb. That consists the verb phrase. And the prefix and pronoun suffix, in some case, there are some particles. And as you know well, the prefix divided into two series. The prefix one, we say, the first series of the prefixes that indicates the direction of the action or motion or affective aspect. And prefix series two, we say prefix two, the second series, it represents the optative mood, mean. Finally, this pronominal suffix, the first and second person and plural, it's a general opinion. Okay, from here, I explain the set of the verb phrases. As you know, Tangut has so several the kinds of prefixes, and the prefix series one and two. Generally to say, they have the same initials, and they have some kind of the correspondence between prefix one and two. Phonetically. So, please remember this prefix one. I say from my reconstruction, it's I say qui. So this is the real from the real samples. It means the castle. Case marker, and this is the prefix one, and this is main vowel. From here, I say the vowels are underlined, and the element in question. So I emphasize it by red color. So actually, it's not so easy to decide the direction of the motion. But here, probably I suggest this meaning to the speaker. So he went into the castle. And second, of course, you know where, but this is one of the table of the set of independent forms and suffixes of tangled pronominals. So this independent form, the sound and characters same suffix, and it's divided into first and second and third, and plural it's not individual form for pronominal, but I mean so after the noun this kind of the morphing that means plurals, and probably it's corresponded to the suffix after verb. And here the late professor Nishida Tatsuo, in his proposal, the agent dual, sounds a suffix indicating. So now from here we test, but just we show the this kind of the verb agreement. It's popular to grammatical phenomena in Tibetan Burman languages. For example, first character is the top of the sentence, and the last character is same and same sound, and that means I get alphabetic way. And in this sentence, so this kind of the agreement, so independent form between independent form and so the suffix form. So we return to this tangled morpheme quill. Actually, it's it has various of functions. First, so I say it includes belongs to prefix series 1. I mean direction of action or operative, and in some case, in particular compounds, it shows some case markers. Verb suffix are making a dual of the agent. So now we will attest it. Actually, so this morpheme in the previous dictionaries, I think not quite enough for the explanation for this morpheme. For example, in Professor Kuchanov, through the slogan and grammatical word, it's all. And also in Professor Li Fangwen, it's probably same, not enough for the explanation. And from here, we use, for my previous reconstruction, this Zaraj initial I means neutral high value. So it is same as Professor Gong's key and Professor Nishida's key. Here are the samples from given by the late Professor Nishida Tatsuo. So actually first I disagreed with his idea. Why? I explain. So I analyzed the sample series 1, so namely this A and B. This is a correspondent by word by word. So please see this sentence A. The element in question is here. Actually, after bab. But is it suffix? We cannot decide it. Because here, the final character means it also bab. And sentence number B is also after bab. Oh, okay. But why Professor Nishida decided it, the suffix? It's possible. So as a prefix of the final verb, I think. So in these cases, so I cannot agree with him. So because we cannot decide it, prefix or suffix, at least in these short samples, we cannot explain it. Next. Oh, yeah, probably so. In C and E, this is the correspondence of the word by word meaning. Yeah, after this underlined by Professor Nishida, and the sequence, it's as a verb phrase of this sentence. After verb, we can observe this element. But actually, in sentence number C and E, so this is my following for the meaning. So Professor Nishida's sample has no agent inside this sentences. No subject so appears here. Only D. We can see. We can observe. Probably agent or object. Yeah, I explained it. This is the sentence. So father, mother, and so first person singular and plurals and case marker, house. Okay, this is the verb phrase. The meaning of this sentence: our father and mother should permit us to live our household life. So this the blue font means subject, and this green font are object. But which pair is dual? So we can decide it. Father and mother, a pair. And this one? So, probably in the sentence, it means the object in this sentence. So, in my previous expression, the samples given by Professor Nishida, I think so weak, a little. But in my previous work, I can observe such kind of phenomena. Please see the sentence number three. So, in this case, we can observe after verb. So we can observe this element. But this sample, this means Avalokiteshvara Sutra. So that was how to say block printed style. And in my previous work, I thought it the mistake of the arrangement of the blocks. I tried to find any more proper samples for denying the Professor Nishida. But unfortunately, I found the proper example. I have to apologize to Professor Nishida sensei. So in this sentence, clearly you can find the two persons inside this simple sentence. So in this sentence, first two characters meaning we. So first singular and plurals. As next, the two persons apparently. And after verb, we can find this element. After then, so I analyzed my previous samples. All cases, the subjects are this kind of. Of course, I can find it in the contents, in the text. So that means two of us. I think in my previous samples, such as this one. Next one is same. This sentence, the sentence without a subject in this short samples, but actually the real subject of this sentence this is the two of us. So of course, basically, I think that the elements qui so shows some kind of the dual marker as a dual marker, but we can find so many exceptions actually. For example, please see this number 7. Number 7 apparently inside this sentence, Ananda and Lavra, so two persons, but without any kinds of suffix. Why? And please see number 8, two Buddha, and this Tathagata. This is the subject of this sentence, two, but without any kinds of suffix. So why? I think in case such as the short or simple sentences, we cannot observe such elements. Here, we return to the original text. For example, look, it's so long sentence. And here, this is, so this means we, and the main verb, and the suffix. So, this is the real sentence from my previous work, and so, now I show you the first sentence. The first part means at the time the boy and girl said to Suddhana. This means boy and girl, two persons. And from here to the end of the these lines, actually they just inside the conversation. So we return to our samples. From here to here, so we can observe such the sentences including suffix qui inside only composition. And so please see this is my sample number 4. So this so we two person, but who is two person here? The boy and girls are located so far from here. This is my short conclusion. The suffix this qui appears in not short and simple sentence, but long and complicated sentences, in which it is not easy to know the subject. I cannot restrict subject because in Professor Nishida's sample, sample D. So I think these two subject and object, but in case we cannot decide only subject because subject are two persons. And I will finish. I think the suffix qui is I think not obligate, just a reminder for the reader. And is it possible from the viewpoint of Tibetan-Burman languages? Some languages in Tibetan-Burman do have a special expression for this kind of the dual persons. Type A is by verb suffix as tangut, and type B is noun suffix or a special form of pronominals. Pronominals. So this is from Professor Nagano Yasuhiko from Japan. This is Jaron language, and so please see the first singular and dual. So so actually Jaronic language shows us some kind of the feature of dual. So this prefix and suffix, especially please mark this chi, applicate chi. And so this is a real sentence, chigyo kama de chiko. Is it right, Monsensei? The meaning of this sentence, two of us will arrive. So I think this chi is phonetically not so far from tangut qui, because before the the birak, so it's possible to change to the applicate chi from the in front of the central vowels. And next one is I think it's not good samples. But some language has a category dual in the pronominal forms, including like k morpheme. So please see this is the pronominals and the real term nanik. So all the forms of dual of pronominals in Atsi language has this kind of the ik as the dual marker. This is my conclusion of Bani. Actually, this Kui, Max Bua, the agent, and the suffix appears in much short and simple but long complicated sentences. It functions as, I think, just a reminder. Of course, I don't know the old language of Tibet Burman, actually, I think such kind of type of the expression called markers, so I think close to Jeromic languages. We have so more future tasks. The material of mine is restricted in a Buddhist text. So we can find the Buddhist text. This is my future tasks. And of course, you know, inside the Buddhist text, it is so hard to find the dual subject. Bhikkhuni and Bhikshuni. But they are not two persons, Bhik and Bhikkhuni. Including the prosperous Buddhist monks and nuns. It means not dual, plurals. From the context, we can find some kind of the subject, dual or not. And next task is it possible from the view of the Tibetan language? Because I'm so poor at the modern languages, and please give me some example from yours. Thank you.